haven't seen the government being significantly scared of the terroristic acts that come from the violent side of Antifa and BLM, regardless of the damage it's caused. Granted, it hasn't caused damage to our democracy. It's just caused a lot of damage in other areas. But I do see the government being significantly scared of any right-wing terrorism or potential right-wing terrorism. And this isn't media that I'm talking about, this is the government. Though media does play a pretty huge role in crafting the general public's perceptions. As I was hate-watching a number of right-wing YouTube videos over the past couple days, I ran across several channels, including, you know, Matt Christensen, who I like to hate-watch normally, who seriously asked the question, and this is paraphrased, because this is based on a collage of what I've heard several other people say.
Well, I mean, if Biden wasn't guilty of something and the election wasn't rigged, then why does he need all this protection? Maybe it's Biden who's in the wrong if this many people hate him so much they want him dead.
Now, I'm sure that that sort of thought passes through many people's minds, but it passes through. It's temporary. It's momentary. People usually don't consider it enough that they would have a great desire to spread it to a huge online audience. But let me guess, it's like Schrodinger's douchebag. Whether it's a joke or not, or whether you're really serious or not, depends on the audience's reaction. Now granted, there are some people who think that I do that with everything. There are many things that I talk about in some of my videos that the whole point is to try to see if people can poke holes in whatever it is. If I'm wrong, I want to know where I'm wrong. And I'm one of the first to admit when I'm wrong. I mean, if you search my videos for I was wrong, you come up with at least 10 results. And those are just the ones that I put I was wrong in the title. There's plenty of others. I don't understand why being wrong terrifies so many people. I mean, maybe I understand a little bit, but perhaps it's that some of these people have never really considered it before. They don't let themselves consider such things, at least not enough to prepare for. And to be wrong would require that they rethink a whole bunch of things. Well, I have no problem with having to rethink a bunch of things. I mean, I've gotten used to it. I hope it's something I'll always be able to do. And maybe some people just don't get that. Maybe that's just not a part of other people's moral codes. I have a very strict moral code. It's very particular to me and my issues, all of my issues, my mental issues, all the things that I do to keep myself in check. I don't really talk about it much. I mean, it's not a one-size-fits-all kind of thing. Moral codes that work best for me and my problems is not going to be what works best for someone else, so, you know, that's why I don't talk about them. There was a person who recently said that they were unsubscribing because they think that I state what my positions are based off of what other people say, that I change my views based on what's popular, or that I craft the views that I state in my videos based on people's comments. They said that I was a fraud, and I was really taken aback by this. You know, as I said, some people just don't seem to get the idea that some people are willing to change their views based on new information. I do this a lot. As I said, search my videos, do it yourself, look for yourself. But back to what was supposed to be the subject at hand. People are seriously arguing that because Biden has so much military protection right now, that it makes him suspicious. Many of these same people try to argue that the rioting that came from the far left was far more damaging to our democracy than the storming of the Capitol building. I don't really know what to say to these people. I mean, yeah, the rioting was awful. It obviously ruined more businesses, caused more damage, destroyed more individual lives, and it most certainly lasted a lot longer. But it wasn't a plot to kidnap or even kill politicians. It wasn't disrupting the crucial process of selecting the president. It wasn't a real threat to our democracy. It was a threat to the cities that had them, yes, but it wasn't a threat to our democracy. Should media have been taking the riots from the left more seriously? Absolutely. Nobody will forget CNN saying, "mostly peaceful protests," and even writing it at the bottom of the screen, while showing burning buildings behind them. I've made multiple videos about how awful mainstream media is. They're willing to pit groups against each other for views, for clicks, for advertising dollars. This doesn't mean that what happened at the Capitol wasn't really that bad. You know, this doesn't mean that when the government says that they want to stop something like what happened at the Capitol from happening again, that it's actually because Biden is guilty of something. No, it doesn't mean that. But you know, always, 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 always,